This is the Gossip Party Harlem Lanes Radio.com and the place to be. We're here every Sunday, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. www.harlemlanesradio.com. The Gospel Party. I'm Willie H. and my host here, Evangelist Show Yvette,
hey,
in the house.
I'm back, y'all. I was gone for a minute. I was on kid duty over there.
Yeah, you. I see you was in the teacher mode.
I was homeschooling, schooling. All
yeah.
That.
I don't know about you, but I am hot.
It's a little warm. I'll give you that.
Yeah, it's warm.
A little bit warm.
Well, but it actually that. But that's great
that's
weather.
Thing,
it is a great thing because we are having a lot of good weather in Buffalo,
we don't get
New
that
York.
Too often, so
yeah.
And Jay's up is on the line with us. We're gonna interview her in just a minute, so she knows about that bad weather.
Right. So, but we having good weather. How's your weather? Well, we got Jay Graham on the line. How's your weather, Jay?
It's beautiful.
Okay, is what's the degree? 80 degrees? 90?
It feels close to that. I don't know if it's that hot now that the sun is going, but it's definitely, it was a beautiful day today.
Okay. All right, great. So now we got Jay Graham on the line, y'all. And Jay Graham is a photographer, a professional photographer. And Jay, what we're going to let you do, you tell us who you are. What you like, how did your business get started, or how, you know, you got in photography, and, you know, and then we'll dig deeper. Of course, I'll dig deeper.
And I'll make sure that I, you know, stop digging if it hurts.
Okay.
All right, Jay, tell us.
Yeah, Jay, tell us a little bit about your business.
Okay, well, I've been in business professionally since 05. Got into photography years ago. When my great uncle, you know, actually introduced me to photography, gave me my first camera and set the head. So after that time, you know, I guess in about 2000, 2001, I started assisting. And I assisted with a lot of really great photographers, doing a lot of commercial work, weddings and things, you know, like that. But that, you know, wasn't really my calling. I said, you know, because I really like dealing with down to earth, real people, children. So doing commercial stuff wasn't really what I was geared for. So, you know, when I decided I wanted to start my business in 05, that's what I did. I did events, I do events and portraits.
So what are some of your more famous or popular photographs that you've taken, or some of your more popular events that you have hosted?
Oh, you said, say that again, I'm sorry.
Tell me a little bit about some of your more famous photography.
Okay, let's see. I don't know how famous it is, because like I said, I'd really rather deal with people that aren't famous. I've done a lot of commercial work assisting, or, you know, like runway stuff where you meet, you know, you're meeting celebrities, but I think the everyday person is really, you know, really my target audience. That's what, you know.
Who are some of the celebrities you've dealt with?
Say it again?
Who are some of the celebrities you've dealt with?
Oh, boy. See, Dionne Warwick, Kanye West, what's his name? Who hosts America's Got Talent? Nick Cannon.
I wish I had pictures of those.
Now, where are those pictures? Where can we find those pictures?
I think I might have sent you a few of them. I didn't send you all of them because, you know, it's what I've done, but it's not really what I do.
Right.
But,
I gotcha.
You know, yeah. I mean, I've dealt with, I can't even imagine, you know, the amount of celebrities that I've actually, you know, dealt with on, you know, the photography, on a business level. But they've all been through, you know, assisting with other photographers.
So I hear what you're saying. What you're saying is that the celebrity to you is the local man, woman, boy, and girl. So the people that you see every day, we're looking at a picture right now. It looks like it's a photograph of a woman and two women on a subway station. And it looks so natural. It's so relaxed and calm and beautiful. You know, it just kind of looks like they're in their natural state. It actually looks like it is at the end of the day, and they just tired and ready to go home.
Yeah, on their way home.
Yeah. Yeah, that was one of those shots. It was the end of the night. I was actually working the parade out in Brooklyn.
Okay.
And this was one of those shots. It was the end of the night. Everybody was pooped. It must have been about, it was like 1 o'clock in the morning. And I just asked them because I think they just look so nice. You could tell that, it was the end of the day, but they still look really nice. I asked them if I could get this shot. And they let me, And I think the best shot is the one that you ask for.
Yeah, some of the pictures that I really like, Jay, is some of those, a lot of those black and whites, and when you actually showcase in real life, and you could tell some of those wasn't prepped. It was something that you got the moment.
Shots.
Yeah, candid shots. And I really love those. One of the things I'm going to tell you right away that I like as I started looking through some of your pictures, and I'm sorry, I couldn't get all of them on here, but some of the things I like was the imagery that you give us black males, because there's a lot of imagery out there on the internet, pictures, and the imagery you give us black male is very human, very loving, very sensitive. And I'm gonna actually let me just show this. You got pictures of men, regular men, doing regular things, and then you got pictures of men with with their sisters or their brothers. You got one picture, this beautiful picture of a little kid and the male in the background holding, and you can tell he's adoring the child. Yeah, and other pictures, you got this guy with a dog. But I like the imagery you give of us black men. You kind of show us in a different, more positive,
really
humane, humane light. I really love your pictures. Of the black man, even with the gentleman with the camera, very professional.
You can see the softness in his eyes.
Yeah,
there's nothing that's threatening about the pictures that you're looking at.
Right,
it's not that common imagery that you see on a daily basis that shows that it's some type of thug mentality.
Right.
Let's just say what we're talking about.
Right.
You're showing what the real character of the black man is, and I don't know if you're looking to necessarily to pull out a more positive image of the black man, but it is something that we're seeing here, and I really appreciate this too. I hadn't had the opportunity to glance at the pictures, and as I'm looking at them now, I'm actually really filled with joy, because a lot of times, media just portrays the African-American male as such this downtrodden thug of a man that really has the worst character in the world. And what we're seeing here through your photography is men who are normal.
Brothers.
You know what I'm saying? And I hate to say that, because this is what it is, people.
Right, right.
A lot of times,
exactly.
The normal that we have is that people are, the black male is, for one,
they're inferior, they're mean, and sensitive, they're brutal.
Yes, you got all the words tonight. I'm like,
they're dangerous.
Negative images.
And
exactly.
When you see Jay pictures, you see manhood as...
You do, and
black male as being humane.
You do, and Jay, I want you to speak to this. What gave you that desire to want to take those types of pictures? Was that your intention to give the black man a positive outlook, or was it just pictures that you were just taking in general?
I think any time you're showing somebody's artwork, it definitely speaks of who they are, and I've always seen black men in very powerful, comforting roles, in my eyes. I mean, what the media shows is so different from how I know black men to be.
Right.
So I want to put out there what it is that I see, and I think more of what I want to see more of. Because I think, when you're putting these images out there, they're also serving as role models a lot of times.
Yeah.
And I just noticed, during my era, that black, especially black fathers, are doing a lot more. They're doing so much more in this generation than I've ever seen
you.
Them do before now.
Thank you, Jay. I'm so happy to hear you say that. I am so happy just to let you know why I said it like that is because even when I go to church and a lot of the black women, We're not perfect. I'm not saying us black men are perfect, but what I'm saying is
no man that, is perfect.
Right, right. But I think we've stepped our game up a little, but even that doesn't sometimes seem enough. And so by you saying that, you see hardworking black men trying to do things, trying to accomplish and playing a role.
Picture. Right. She's saying that big picture because the men that you take the pictures of, are these people that are close to you or are these just general people that you see out in the public?
You catch some of both.
Some of both?
You get some of both, yes.
Okay. Because what I was getting to was the fact that it's not staged.
Right, right.
You know,
right.
It's like this is who this individual is. This, you know, a non-threatening individual that will help you, hug you, and love you. You know what I'm saying? We were actually watching a show one day, and the discussion came up about if you dropped, you know, as a female, black or white female or whatever your race is. Hang on one second, Jay. We're just going to grab this call.
We got somebody on the line, Jay. Hello. Hello, this is the Gospel Party, HarlemLanesRadio.com. Who's on the line?
This is Chandra.
Hey, Chandra, what's up? You on the show, Chandra, so make sure you whatever you say is it's going to add to the show. What's going on?
I was just calling because I knew you wasn't going to pick up your cell phone.
Okay, and?
So, Mother here's refrigerator broke down, so we're going to ask if you can put food in, our refrigerator.
Not a problem.
Okay.
Not
all
a problem.
Right.
God bless you.
Have a blessed afternoon.
All right, you too.
Love you, Chandra.
Well, y'all know I'm going to have a full...
Call us if you need us.
Yeah. My refrigerator is going to be full, so I'm going to have a good time.
It's going down tonight, huh? All right.
All right. Let me get Jay back on the line. Hey, Jay, you there? Jay, you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, wonderful. Good. I'm sorry about that, Jay. All right, so we was talking.
We were just again allowing Jay to kind of elaborate on where these men came from. You know, okay. Were these just, you know, men who were already in the community, or were these people that were staged? Because it's easy to stage a picture, but to catch these men in their natural element makes it all the better to me to see that there's a positive male image out there, black, white, or whatever his race may be. But the situation that I was thinking about, where we were having a conversation one time, Jay, and what happened was we were talking to a group of women, and we asked the women to look at some photographs, and if you drop something out of your cart and this individual was to pick it up and bring it to you, what would your response be? Seemed pretty natural, right? If you drop, you know, a can out of your cart and somebody picked it up and then gave it back to you, you would normally just be like, oh, okay, thank you. But what we did was we showed the images before we set up the situation to say, what would you do if this individual came up to you? And with some of the women, even some of the black women, it was like a guy in a hoodie. Well, I don't think that because a guy has on a hoodie that you should be afraid of him, but the media has made us become fearful of one another and even fearful of our own people. Yeah. And I hate to say that because I feel that we should get outside of the boundaries of racism, but I don't think the racism is not dead, obviously. But, you know, the thing is, we should be able to hopefully one day look at people as people. And Jay, we just want to commend you because your photography is showing people as people.
Right. And so and it's based, I could tell it's based on your relationship, how you kind of see the world. You helping us to see your worldview. Jay, is that, would that be correct, that you helping us to see your worldview?
Exactly. You know how I see things, you know. Because if children get to see this and they can say, well, you know, I don't have to be a strong man and still be a loving father. You know, those are the things that are important to me because there were so many negative images that were fed constantly. Now,
Jay, we've seen some of your pictures. Now, what would be your ideal of a photograph project or projects? What would be your idea of a great project?
Well, there were a couple of images in here. I let them escape. But I'm working on something right now, and it's Fathers and Daughters, because that's something that's going to be near and dear.
Nice. Well, you had a bunch of father and daughter pictures that I actually saw, and that's what kind of got my juice flowing about that. Now, Jay, I just want to ask you some. Are you married, Jay?
No.
All right. You have any children?
No.
Brothers and sisters? Any brothers and sisters?
Yes, I have brothers and sisters. I have two younger brothers and an older sister.
Okay. All right. So now, are you the oldest?